Hey everybody, it's just about feeding time and I wanted to get a quick video of all the minnows while they're down this end of the tank. We've also got one of my crayfish visible right there in front, tucked away underneath that piece of wood. So I'm still treating the tank for cyanobacteria with the ChemiClean aquarium treatment. And I'm still letting some of the plants sort of adapt to their changed environment. Some of them are growing up and out of the water now, so the leaves are curling up a little bit. And of course, I'm also trying to let that log that I put in here get a little more saturated with water, etc., etc. So it won't be too much longer. I'll be shooting a video doing the big reveal and showing everybody how I've got the tank scaped out now. It doesn't necessarily have to be permanent. In fact, I will already give away the fact that it's not going to be permanent because the log is so buoyant. I've got it weighted down with rocks and I've got it sort of wedged underneath the frame. The plastic crossbar supports across the top of the tank. I've got a big flat rock wedged between that and the piece of wood to sort of hold it down under the water. So as time goes on and it develops, loses its buoyancy, I should say, then we will be able to move those rocks around. You see that? That's how strong those crayfish are. Now I know a log sitting on the bottom of the water like that, or a little branch sitting on the bottom of the water like that, because of the buoyancy, isn't very heavy. But I've seen those crayfish just push big, large branches out of the way. Stuff, you know, more akin to this size. Those crayfish just lift it up and push it out of the way. They're like little tanks, little construction equipment. And, of course, they burrow and dig and do all kinds of stuff in the tank. Really fascinating animals. I have no doubt they will eventually crawl up and out. As open as the tank is now and as easy as access is to the surface, it's going to be a matter of maybe days before we don't even have crayfish in this tank anymore. But we'll see. You never know. We might find some that just aren't really climbers and explorers, but most of the time crayfish do tend to get up and out of the tank and go for walks at night. And of course, when they're in a fish tank, they can't walk back to the water's edge and get back in the way they can when they're at the stream. But if you're out of the stream at night and you shine a flashlight around, you will often find crayfish several feet from the water. They come right out of the water and they crawl around on land looking for food. So again, at night, it's not unusual for them to crawl up and out of a fish tank if they've got the opportunity. So there you go, just another quick look. I got to get on with feeding everybody, but I saw the crayfish that was out and I saw all those minnows sitting in a big school right down here at the end of the tank that I can show you without giving away any of the secrets of the tank. All of the scaping I did was more towards the center and the right-hand side of the tank as opposed to down here. We don't have a whole lot different going on, although once we start discussing what I've actually done, you'll see that it is a little bit different down at this end too. So let's see if that crayfish doesn't hoist that piece of wood up and out of his way again. It's neat watching them use their little claws on their walking feet to root around through the gravel looking for food. They're a fantastic cleanup crew. They'll eat just about anything. And of course, you can see they are, you know, foragers. They root around through the gravel and they pick out little dead detritus, plant debris. Of course, they'll eat any kind of dead fish. They'll occasionally catch the fish. They're opportunistic hunters. They will snatch a fish out of the water if they get the opportunity. They'll eat just about anything. So, all right, everybody, I'm going to leave it there because he looks like he's found something to munch on for a little bit. And as I said, I got to get on with feeding everybody. So make sure you're subscribed. You don't want to miss the big reveal. It'll be coming up, I guess, probably this weekend I'll do it. Today is Tuesday, so that's just a few days from now. We'll get a much better look at this tank and we can go over all of the things I've done so far and some of the things I'd like to do once that wood becomes a little more waterlogged, as I said. So thanks again for watching this one. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe. And don't forget, this is my 125-gallon native tank. So thanks again, and I will see you real soon on the next one.